I'm Brian, the Program Director here at Code Institute. Today we're going to talk about GitHub. Don't forget to like, follow, share, and subscribe. GitHub is the number one software repository hosting platform where more than 73 million software developers come together to store, manage, and contribute to their own and others' projects and their associated digital documents. While GitHub and its competitors are primarily used for hosting project code developed in various programming languages, these tools can be used to save and collaborate on almost any digital document. But today, we'll focus on how GitHub is used to work with software projects. You may not be familiar with GitHub, but you'll quickly become very comfortable using this fantastic resource once you embark on your journey into software development. So what is GitHub used for? GitHub allows people to store their work as well as collaborate with others. The platform facilitates the interaction of people who can view, contribute, and share each other's work. They can discuss and fix errors, as well as repurposing existing solutions for other projects when building their own. Now, source code that runs from start to finish, doing what it was designed to do, is ideal. And that's what GitHub attempts to assist. It provides us with an environment that encourages the improvement of code. It also provides a system with which coders can keep track of the changes made during the coding process. Sometimes it can be challenging to grasp the labor involved, the number of hours needed to string together often millions of lines of code. Even the most basic app requires excellent attention to detail, or it will fail to operate. Sometimes a second set of eyes or even a helping hand is needed, be they from a colleague or an external collaborator. And GitHub facilitates those extra pairs of eyes. Now, what does GitHub mean? For its users, GitHub means many things. For some, it's a code sharing and publishing resource. It's also a networking site where developers can work together. But it's a lot more than this too. Having started as a developer's collaborative platform, GitHub is now the most significant cloud-based storage space for software projects that exists on the planet. With Twitter, you communicate by sharing tweets. On Facebook, you communicate by sharing cat videos. You communicate by sharing photographs of food on Instagram. And with GitHub, you communicate by sharing code and other artifacts that go into creating a software project. GitHub allows programmers to duplicate code from a project and safely work on it without changing the code within the original project. In other words, you can continue to develop an application without affecting other work being done. And when you're finished working on your copy, it's reviewed, and if there are no breaking changes, your code will be merged with the original source code, thus contributing to the overall functionality of the project. As the name suggests, GitHub can be divided into the Git part and the Hub part. Let's talk about Git first. Git is an open source version control system that lets developers manage changes to a software project's code. Version control is essential when working on software projects. It is a system used in managing and changes to documents, computer programs, large websites, and other collections of information. Without version control in place, it's a case of when, not if, you will lose your changes and possibly entire files. While Git revolutionized version control, GitHub gave us a staging platform that let developers build and share prototypes, collaborate on projects, edit and contribute to each other's code, and give project stakeholders a chance to view in-progress work. The Hub part is not nearly as difficult to grasp. It's a community of like-minded individuals who participate in working on code and solutions together. These collaborations can be private or public. It's all about the collaborative effort, from small in-house development teams to global communities working on massively scaled projects. Collaborators come together to create, review, and improve code, as well as deriving new ideas and helpful solutions from the uploaded project repositories. Often it can be intimidating to introduce yourself to a community of strangers, let alone strangers with technical knowledge that might far surpass your own. GitHub can relieve some of these fears because a collaborative attitude and mindset is fostered due to the structures and process that are built into the Hub. So how do we use GitHub? Using GitHub is relatively straightforward. However, of course, it helps if you're a software developer. Let's look at how you sign up. Before using GitHub, you need to sign up for an account. A basic account is free, but there are also paid for team and enterprise versions. Because GitHub runs on Git, you will generally want to download Git onto your computer. It then needs to be installed and configured. If you want to put a project live on GitHub, you will have to create a repository. This is where your project will live. To create a repository, click on the plus drop-down menu and follow the instructions. GitHub offers an intuitive web-based interface that includes issue tracking, wikis, REST APIs, and rich GUI and command line tools for Windows, Mac, Linux, and even mobile devices. You can create and build a profile and upload projects known as repositories in order to share and connect with others by following their accounts. And while many users store programs and code projects, nothing is preventing you from keeping text documents or other file types in your project folders. GitHub encourages users to create a repository to place their current work for others to view or indeed edit and correct. On GitHub, you can star, watch, and fork. But what are they? Forking lets you safely make a copy of someone else's project and work on it yourself without affecting the original. Watching gives you updates when changes are made to a project that you are following. Starring is GitHub's version of the like button on Facebook. It's a voting system that enables developers to vouch for projects that they think are excellent. Apart from benefiting from the features we just covered, there are other benefits for developers who use this platform. For example, GitHub Pages. GitHub Pages allow you to showcase your portfolio of work on elegant websites. These sites are fully HTML compliant and can be customized as you see fit. You can also apply free and paid themes to get you up and running quickly with GitHub Pages. Our students at Code Institute use GitHub Pages to showcase their front-end projects and embed links to the source code so that others can see what their work looks like and how it was made, all from one location. This is a great feature. Now, if you're coming to the world of software development for the very first time, some of what we've just covered might sound a bit obscure or technical. So if you've never experienced coding before, then try Code Institute's free 5-day coding challenge. Here you'll learn some of the basics needed for software development, including HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. After 1 hour a day, over 5 days, you'll have built your very first web page or front-end application. So register now through the link in the description below.